Do you have a thyroid problem? Will I conceive and will I become a mother or not? Is that problem which is bothering you? Do you have that fear in your mind that the thyroid imbalance will make you infertile for life? If yes, then please don't worry about it. And we are going to discuss today, how do we manage your thyroid imbalance in a correct way so that you have a higher chances of getting pregnant and have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy child. Namaste, my name is Dr. Tanvi Mayur Patel. I am an endocrinologist, hormone specialist to doctor from Mumbai, India. Now before I begin this video, one important information. If you want to watch this video in Hindi language, then on the I button there is a link. You can click on that link and this video will be played in Hindi language for you. अगर आप इस वीडियो को हिंदी भाषा में देखना चाहते हैं तो ऊपर आई बटन पे और नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में एक लिंक है. अगर आप उस लिंक पे क्लिक करेंगे तो इस वीडियो को आप हिंदी भाषा में पाएंगे. नाउ सी, थायराइड प्रॉब्लम इज अ वेरी कॉमन हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम. नियरली 12% ऑफ द पीपल डेवलप अ थायराइड इम्बैलेंस इन सम ऑर द अदर स्टेज ऑफ देयर लाइफ. And now when we talk about the reproductive age group women, nearly 3-4% of the people have such a thyroid imbalance. Now when you have such a high number of people suffering from the thyroid problem, of course the number of people will be more who will be struggling with the fertility and infertility related problems. So you are not alone in this, and there are plenty many people who are being affected by the similar situation. See, understand, the thyroid hormone controls every part of our body function and the reproductive function is one of it. So when you have any kind of a thyroid imbalance, whether it is hypothyroidism where your thyroid is working less than the requirement, or whether it is a hyperthyroidism when your thyroid is working more than the requirement, in both the situations it can have a detrimental effect on your fertility and your ability to conceive. So how do they affect? What all problems can happen if you have an imbalance in your thyroid hormone? How do we treat it and manage it so that you have a healthy pregnancy? That is what we are going to discuss in today's topic. So the very first question a person has in their mind, since I have a thyroid problem, will I ever conceive? Will I ever become a mother? Answer is yes, absolutely yes, provided your thyroid is controlled and it's in the right optimum balance. And secondly, you or your partner do not have any other reason for not to conceive and have infertility issues. Thyroid imbalance problems are very easily manageable and very easily treatable. So do not worry about it and just be positive and focus on your right treatment and the right monitoring of your blood test. If you do this and if everything is other factors are fine, you will have no reason why you or your partner will not conceive. Now let's understand what all imbalances in your periods can happen when you have a thyroid imbalance. Now see, I have made a separate video on this, how thyroid and periods are connected with each other and what all imbalances can happen. If you have not watched that video, I will request you to watch that video so that you will understand more in detail. Now since today's topic is more of a thyroid and fertility and infertility, my discussion will remain in this topic itself. So the very first issue can happen to women when they have a thyroid imbalance is amenorrhea. Amenorrhea is nothing but an absence of a menstrual period. So if you have an absence of a menstrual period, it will become difficult for you to conceive. Second problem happens is that these women have issues in their ovulation. Now what is ovulation? See, when a woman has a monthly cycle, at the mid of the cycle, there is a release of an egg and this egg gets released from the ovary. This action of the release of the egg is called as a ovulation. So when a person has a thyroid imbalance, their ovulation is not correct. And many of the times these women have a condition called as an unovulation, where the egg is not released from the ovary. So if the egg is not released from the ovary, of course you have no chance of getting pregnant, isn't it? So release of the egg is a very, very important in conceiving. People who have a thyroid imbalance, either their ovulation is irregular or they have no ovulation at all, and both of that makes a conceiving a little difficult. Third issue happens, and that is a luteal phase defect. Now, what is a luteal phase? See, the monthly cycle, which is ideally of a 28 days, ovulation happens at the mid of the cycle around 14th day. The stage after the ovulation is called as a luteal phase. During the luteal phase, there is a very high amount of a progesterone in your body. Now, this progesterone hormone, we also call it as a pregnancy hormone. Now, what is its action? See, once the egg gets fertilized, okay, this egg has to attach on your uterus, okay, and this attachment of the embryo on the uterus is called as an implantation. So if you have a right amount of progesterone level in your body, then this progesterone will make sure and will ensure that the internal lining of the uterus, which we call it as an endometrium, is a receptive to accept this embryo attachment, and that is an implantation. So if you do not have a right amount of progesterone in your body, this implantation process will not happen. And if that does not happen, then again you will have a difficulty in conceiving. There are many times it has been found that the woman has got an embryo and there wasn't fertilization of the egg has happened. But due to the luteal phase defect and the progesterone deficiency, this implantation could not happen, and due to which the early miscarriage has happened. In fact, many a times it has been also seen that when women gets a monthly cycle, along with the blood, there is a lot of clots which gets released. And many of the times, these clots can be of an embryo also, which is an early indication of a miscarriage. So due to the luteal phase defect also, you might have a difficulty in conceiving and accepting the conception. Another problem happens when you have a thyroid imbalance is the other hormonal issues. So when you have a high level of the TSH in your body, there's one another hormone called as a prolactin, and their level also gets disturbed. And when your prolactin hormone gets disturbed, again your periods becomes irregular, again your cycle becomes unovulatory, and that again can complicate your chances of a conceiving. Another hormonal problem can happen is that there is a not only decrease in the progesterone level, but also there is a decrease in the one another hormone called as a sex hormone binding globulin, and there can be an elevated level of the estrogen. All of these conditions can also complicate the chances of a conception. Many a times the people who have a higher level of the TSH hormone, they also have an imbalance of an insulin hormone, and that insensitivity of the insulin can happen, and again that can make it difficult for you to conceive. So you see, when you have a one thyroid hormone imbalance, many other hormonal imbalance can also happen. So it is very important that you control your thyroid imbalance. Automatically other hormones will fall into. Another problem which can happen if you have a thyroid imbalance is an imbalance in basal body temperature, or a BBT. Now, what is this basal body temperature? It is a kind of our internal body temperature. And a thyroid hormone is very important in maintaining this basal body temperature. If for any reason, if there is an imbalance of your thyroid hormone, even the basal body temperature will be imbalanced. Now, why do we need this basal body temperature? See, once an egg and a sperm meets each other, an egg gets fertilized. And this fertilized egg, we call it as an embryo. This embryo is nothing but it's a kind of a cell. This cell will now multiply by various cell divisions and it will grow. For this cell divisions to happen, you need an optimum level of the basal body temperature. If your basal body temperature is not adequate, then the cell divisions will not happen. And if the cell divisions will not happen, the embryo will not grow and the embryo will not survive, and again a miscarriages can happen. So this problem can also happen if you have a thyroid imbalance. Again, one more thing can happen when you have an imbalance in your thyroid hormone. A person usually feels fatigue and tired. And when you have a lot of fatigue and tired, this can also reduces your chance of being sexually active with your partner, and that can again decreases your possibility of conception. Another issue, since in case of a thyroid imbalance, your periods becomes irregular. And when your periods are irregular, it is difficult to calculate your own fertile period. And if your fertile period is not calculated correctly, and if you do not do a right kind of a physical connection with your partner, again you are missing out on your chances of conceiving. So this point also has to be kept in mind. Another problem which can happen when you have a thyroid imbalance, many women have a very heavy bleeding, and due to this they have anemia, and due to this anemia also your chances of conceiving can get reduced. Now understand that fertility is never an individual person's problem. It is always a couple's issue. When a couple undergo through infertility treatment, we also have to see whether there are male factor issues and there are female factor issues. See, thyroid problem happens more commonly in women. However, that does not mean that the men don't get a thyroid problem. Men also encounters a hypothyroid situation. Then what will happen in men at that time? First problem can happen is that such men have a low sex drive and their interest in sex is reduced. Secondly, this imbalance of a thyroid can have an impairment of the quality and the quantity of the sperm. Many a time the sperm are very weak and they do not have the power to fertilize the egg. Many a times due to the imbalance of the thyroid hormone, the motility of the sperm is also affected, and due to which they do not have the capacity to fertilize the egg. So all these issues can happen in men if their thyroid hormone is not kept in a right range. So now we saw that what all problems can happen if your thyroid hormone is imbalanced. Now let's understand that if at all you conceive and if your thyroid hormone is not in a balance, then what all complications can happen? See, complications can happen to mother and it can also happen to an unborn child. So let's see what all complications can happen in a woman. So first, women have a higher chances of a miscarriage. Women have a higher chances of developing anemia and higher chances of developing a condition called as a preeclampsia. When you have a preeclampsia, you tend to have a high blood pressure also. Thyroid imbalance can again increases the risk of a stillbirth. Now let's see what complications can happen to an unborn child. So the first of all, the child can have a physical and a mental development retardation. Such fetus can also have a low birth weight and they can even born before the due date, that is a premature deliveries can also happen. So these all complications can also happen. Now since thyroid problem is so common in our society, so is it important that every woman should undergo a thyroid screening and testing? Well, ideally the answer is yes. Every woman should undergo this testing, and if there is any issue, has to be addressed accordingly. Especially in today's time, the people get married at a later age and they also do a family planning. And due to that, there is an advancement in the conceiving age. And due to that, again, as you age more, your fertility also decreases. You tend to have a higher chances of developing a thyroid problem, and all of that can make it little difficult for you to conceive. So it is very important that before the pregnancy planning, you should get your blood test done and check whether you have a thyroid problem or not. Getting tested for every woman is a very important. However, this becomes more important for those people who fall in a high-risk population. Now, what are these high-risk population? The people who I'm going to mention now, they fall in a high-risk population. First, if you have an advanced age. Second, if you have any positive family history where some of the other family members is having a thyroid problem. Third, you are trying for pregnancy and you are not able to achieve a pregnancy. Fourth, if you have a history of a miscarriages in the past. Fifth, if you are overweight or obese person. Sixth, if you have any other hormonal problem like a polycystic ovarian syndrome or a prolactin hormone imbalance or an insulin hormone imbalance. Seventh, if you have any other autoimmune health problem. Now see, people who have one autoimmune health problem have a higher chances of having a second autoimmune problem. And thyroid problems are an autoimmune problem, and due to that, you have a higher chances of developing other autoimmune problems as well. And eighth, if your body has any symptoms which is suggestive of the thyroid imbalance, in all this situation, it becomes very important for you to get tested for your thyroid imbalance and check whether you have such problem or not. And let's say if you have done the blood testing and you're found to have a thyroid imbalance, now what? So very first thing, don't worry and just relax. Go to your nearby thyroid specialist or doctor and get evaluated and get treated. See, hypothyroid condition is a very common condition, and the treatment is also very simple and very easy. You will be prescribed a medication called as a levothyroxine. Now, usually this medicine will start showing its effects in a few weeks time, and it may take few weeks to few months for you to completely come in the optimum range of your thyroid. There have been incidences wherein a person has started taking levothyroxine medication and immediately they have conceived. So it all depends on your individual case. But please keep one thing in mind, that the levothyroxine medicine is not a medication for a infertility. It is a treatment for a hypothyroidism. If you do not have any thyroid imbalance or an antibody level imbalance, then taking this medication may not do any help to you. So please make a note of that, and also keep in mind that these are hormonal medication. Do not self-medicate and talk to your doctor, and if your doctor feels that you are the right candidate for the treatment, then you should consider yourself from taking this medicine. Now let's take another scenario, that you already have a thyroid problem and you are planning for the pregnancy. In that case, what all precautions you need to keep? So very first thing is that you have to inform your doctor. Yes, a pre-planning is very, very important. Because a thyroid condition is a long-term problem, we have seen people taking the same medication for years and years and have never visited a doctor in years to come. So if that is a situation, in that case, you have to visit to your doctor and inform your doctor that you are planning for pregnancy, and then accordingly you can discuss as a team and can work accordingly. Now let's assume that you already have a thyroid problem and you are taking a medication for that and you are planning for a pregnancy. In that situation, what all points to be keep in mind so that tomorrow you do not have a infertility issues. So very first thing is that you need to visit to your doctor immediately and discuss with your doctor that you are planning for a pregnancy. Yes, this is very, very important point. There are many reasons behind that. In many times, especially in the smaller villages, the thyroid condition may be managed by the primary care physicians who may not be completely well versed with all the advancements of the thyroid medical guidelines. So if that is a situation, you might need to visit a close by endocrinologist or a gynecologist doctor who will guide you. Secondly, because thyroid problem is a long-term problem, there have been incidences that a person has not visited doctor for years and years. If that is a situation, again you don't make such mistake. Go visit to your doctor and inform your doctor that you are planning for pregnancy. And due to that, your doctor will advise you the right blood test and might need to change your medication dose as well. Remember that in case of a thyroid and infertility, the problem arises when your thyroid is either not controlled or it is not controlled adequately. So both the points should be keep in mind. Secondly, make sure that your TSH is in the optimum range. Now see, whenever you do a blood test, and when you get a blood test report, in the report there have been mentioned of a reference range or a normal range. Now in case of a TSH, this reference range is very wide. It varies from 0.5 to 4.5 miu per liter, which is a very wide range. Even if your report is in this normal range, your thyroid is not considered in the optimum range. When we talk about the optimum range, the TSH value is 2.5 or little less than that. There have been studies found that when your TSH is kept at 2.5 level, it is very easy for a woman to conceive. And at the same time, there are less chances of the miscarriage. So make sure that your TSH is in the optimum range. And if your TSH is not in the optimum range, your doctor will adjust your medication to bring you in the optimum range. To bring your case into optimum range, it might take few weeks to few months. Again, it depends on your individual case. There have been incidences where a person is complaining of infertility, but when we do their blood test, we find out that their thyroid was completely out of balance and they have been taking inadequate dose of the medication. So please make sure that you don't make such mistakes so that tomorrow you don't cry for no reason and say that my problem happened due to thyroid. If the problem didn't happen due to thyroid, but the problem happened due to you were taking inadequate dose of the medication. Third important point to be keep in mind is that please continue your medicine. Yes, we have seen people stopping their levothyroxine medicine and saying that since now I'm planning for pregnancy, this medication can harm my child, so I'm going to stop the medicine. Don't make such mistake. If you're not going to take a levothyroxine in a correct way, your thyroid will not remain in the right balance. And if it not remains in the right balance, you will have difficulty in conceiving. And if at all you conceive, then you can have a complications which I discussed just now. So please continue your medication. Levothyroxine medicine is not going to harm your child. Rather, if you don't take the medicine, then it can definitely harm your child. So continue your medication. Remember that being a compliant with the medication, with the thyroid testing and monitoring is very, very important in order to have a best of your fertility with the thyroid condition. Fourth point is that make sure you have an adequate amount of iodine in your body. Now see, iodine is a very important micronutrient for your right thyroid functioning. If your body does not have a right amount of the iodine, you can have a thyroid imbalance. For a normal healthy individual, 150 microgram of iodine requirement is there per day. If you are a pregnant or if you are a breastfeeding mother, your iodine requirement can increase up to 250 to 290 micrograms per day as well. So make sure that you are having a sufficient amount of iodine. At the same time, make sure that you are having sufficient amount of the vitamin D, because deficiency of the vitamin D has also been linked with the infertility. And also make sure that you have a sufficient amount of the selenium. Like iodine, selenium is also very important for the right functioning of your thyroid gland and its hormones. There have been studies found that if you have a selenium deficiency, you tend to have a higher chances of the autoimmune problems, and thyroid is one of it. So make sure that you sufficiently take a selenium. You can eat selenium rich food like a Brazil nut, hazelnut, macadamia nuts. These are considered very high in selenium content. Now, since we are talking about the thyroid and fertility and infertility, one very important and a very special topic comes in my mind, and that is a subclinical hypothyroidism. Now, what is a subclinical hypothyroidism? In a layman language, to make you understand, I can call it as a borderline thyroid problem. when a person has a subclinical hypothyroid, this individual may or may not have any symptoms. But when we do the blood testing, the TSH level is found higher than the normal range but less than 10. This condition is called as a subclinical hypothyroid. Whether to treat this condition or not to treat this condition is itself a very controversial topic in a medical science. But there have been incidents found that when we treat subclinical hypothyroid, these women have a very high chances of regaining their fertility and a very high chances of conceiving and a less chances of a miscarriages. So if you feel that your case falls in a subclinical hypothyroid, go visit to your doctor and discuss with your doctor and let your doctor take a decision what to do in your case. Another important consideration is the autoimmunity and an inflammation. Now see, thyroid problem is an autoimmune health problem. And when an autoimmune health problem happens, there are very high level of the antibodies in your blood. And when you talk about the thyroid imbalance, there have been a high level of the antibodies like a TPO, then thyroglobulin, then TRAb antibodies. And when you have a higher chances of having, and when you have a high antibody levels, this can also impair your fertility. This can also make it difficult for your egg to fertilize. It can also increase your chances of a miscarriage, and it also increases the chances of improper implantation. So make sure that you check what are your antibody levels. Now again, like a subclinical hypothyroid, to treat this high level of the antibodies is again a controversial topic. So you can go and visit your endocrinologist doctor and discuss with your doctor whether do you need to get any treated or not. As I told you earlier, that make sure that you have a right balance of the vitamin D and a selenium and iodine, because balance of all these three micronutrients will ensure that your autoimmune problem doesn't occur and your immune system remains in check. So that's what we learned today, how thyroid imbalance can impair the fertility and what all important points you need to keep in mind before you start planning a child. So today we saw that how thyroid imbalance can lead you into infertility and what all special precautions you need to keep in mind so that you have a healthy outcome of the pregnancy. If you have got some good important information after watching this video, please click on the like button. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you get more and more health related information. And then there is a bell icon. If you click there, as and when my new video will be published, you will get instant notification. And if you have any of your personal question pertaining to thyroid, you can leave your question in the comment box. I will try to read as early as possible and answer them as early as I can. Thank you for joining me till now. We will meet again in another video with some new interesting topic. Till then, take care of yourself and namaste.